With the barbaric Christian raiders on one side and these new fundamentalist Muslims on the other, Al-Andalus was crushed. It descended into corruption. A Christian king would provide military aid to a weak Muslim king in return for a substantial payment of gold coin. The whole of Al-Andalus was subjected to this system of extortion. The trouble is, modern Spain chooses to remember this war rather differently. La Reconquista, the Reconquest, is presented as a valiant crusade in which Spain is returned to its rightful Christian owners. This pantomime version of history is personified in many of Spain's national heroes, the greatest of whom is a knight called Guzman el Bueno. Every town in Spain has a street named after Guzman el Bueno. He's one of the country's best-loved historical figures. The story of when Guzman defended the town of Tarifa from Muslim raids is well known in Spain. Guzman's descendants, the Medina Sidonia family, became one of the richest landowners in the country. The Duchess of Medina Sidonia has discovered something remarkable about her illustrious ancestor.
Guzman el Bueno is the first of the Guzman family we know about. He is the founder of the family. He came here and lived in this very house. This is the family archive, although it's more than that. It is a rich source of documents from the medieval period and later.
Was it right that one of your ancestors was involved in the Spanish Armada?
The 7th Duke was involved in that campaign. This document dates from 1288. We know my ancestor was in Al-Andalus a year before because he bought a farm. And this document mentions it. It's a permit for him to export 300 bushels of wheat. Look, you can see the word wheat. And what it says is that he is allowed to take this overseas, to where he is from.
Because of the grammar, you can tell that he comes from overseas, not that he was just visiting from overseas.
Yes, probably it refers to a place which was part of Morocco, much larger then than now, a place where neither wheat nor hay could grow.
The Duchess had discovered that her ancestor, the great Christian knight Guzman el Bueno, was actually a Muslim.
This is really a piece of human history. It dates to 1297. The king refers to Guzman as my vassal because he is a foreigner.
Guzman the vassal.
If it wasn't written here, I wouldn't believe it. It was very common for Muslims to ally themselves with Christian factions, especially when Christians were warring with each other.
It must have been quite a surprise to discover that your ancestor was a Muslim.
Yes, a great surprise. This is because there had been a chronicle which dated back to the 16th century, in which the Guzman family had cleaned up its political and ethnic past. Guzman was said to have been born in León. They didn't just do this with the Guzman family, but with all the families that had doubtful ancestors, ancestors of doubtful race. They cleaned it all up. We have a whole load of documents here from the Spanish register, and they turn everything we know about Spanish history upside down. The Spanish are simply inventing history. They have turned history into a fable.